I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you operation research. In that one, transportation problem. In the transportation problem, I am going to focus over the Vogel approximate method or penalty method or regret method. This is the problem they have given it. This is the source, destination, demand and supply. Now let us solve this problem. First I will construct the box here. I'll construct a complete box. Now divide into 1, 2, 3, 4 part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3 part. 1. 2 and 3. Write the numbers here. 2, 2, 2, 1, 10, 8, 8, 5, 4, 7, 3. Six, eight, eight. Now this is the source O1, O2, O3, supply 3, 7, 5. Now this is the demand here, 4, 3, 4 and 4. First we are going to check whether the system is balanced or no. 3, 7, 5, it will be 15. 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4, it will be 15. The system is balanced. It is a balanced system. Next, draw the line in this way. Now write here row penalties, column penalty, row penalties, column penalty. Now see here. In order to write the row penalty, you have to select smallest value, that is 1, and little bit larger value compared to 1 is 2. 2 minus 1, write 1. Next, the smallest is 4. The next smallest is 5. 5 minus 4, 1. Here the smallest is 3. Next smallest is 6. Therefore, 6 minus 3, 3. Now here, the smallest is 2. Apart from the 2, the next value is 7. The 7 minus 2, 5. Here 3, 2 and 3. That will be 1. The smallest is 2. The next smallest is 5. It will be 3. The smallest value is 1. Next is 4. 4 minus 1, it will be 3. Now, after doing row penalty and column penalty, we have to select the larger among the row and the column. This is the column and this is the row. We have to select larger value. The larger value is 5. Right, show the arrow in this way. 5. After selecting the larger value, now in the column we have to select the smallest value. The smallest value is 2. 2. This is the smallest 2. Now supply is 3, demand is 4. The supply 3, write the smallest value here, 3, and round it out. After rounding it out, this become 3 becomes 0 and this one become 1, and you have to eliminate this part completely. You have to eliminate it. Next, same procedure you have to follow. Next, next here 5 minus 4, again 1. The next smallest is 3 and 6, again it will be 3. Here 10 minus 7, it will be 3. 8 minus 3, it will be 5. 6 minus 5, it will be 1. Here 4 minus 8 or 8 minus 4, it will be 4. 4. Now among the row and the column, you have to select the larger value. The 5 is the larger. Now see here, fly in the, as you move in this column, you have to select the smallest value. Already this is eliminated. Now this is 3 is the smallest value. Now see, the supply is the 5, demand is the 3, therefore write 3 here, and this becomes 0, and remove this entire column. And here it becomes 5 minus 3, it will be 2. Now similar procedure. Now 10, 5 minus 4, again it will be 1. Here 6 or 7, 6 is the smallest. Apart from the 6, the 7 is little bit larger. 7 minus 6, it becomes 1. Similarly here, 10 minus 7, it will be 3. This is eliminated. Now 6 minus 5, 1, it will be 4. This will be 4. Now show the arrow 4 here. The 4 is larger in the column, therefore write 4. Now move upward. Now you have to select the smallest value. The 4 is the smallest. Now see the demand and the supply. The demand is 4, the supply is 7, and write the demand here 4 and round it out and deduct 4 from the 7. It will be 3. It will be 3. Now after deducting, eliminate this. Eliminate it. Next, follow the same procedure. 10 minus 5, 5. Next, 7 minus 6, 1. Here 10 minus 7, 3. 6 minus 5, 1. Among the column and row, you have to select the larger value. The larger value is 5. I will select the 5. Now I will move here. In 10 and 5, I have to select the smallest value. The 5 is the smallest. Then I will see the supply and demand. The supply is 3. I will write 3 here. 3. I will reduce this one by 1. 4 minus 3 is nothing but 1. Now this becomes 0. I will eliminate this part completely. Now remaining part will be here 2. Now directly you can write it. This one, write 1 here. This is the one, write 1. If you add it, it will be 2. This completes the problem. Now we are going to find out the feasible solution here. Feasible solution. Now see how to find out the feasible solution. Feasible solution. We are going to find out. Now how to write feasible solution. Now see here, go for naming here. D1, D2, D3, D4. Now write the feasible solution. X 11 is nothing but 2. Sorry, 3. Circular portion you have to write. Now next is X 23 is nothing but 3. X 24 is nothing but 4. X 31 is nothing but 1. X 32 is nothing but 3. X 33 is nothing but 1. This is called as a feasible solution. Now we have to find out the minimum transportation cost. Let us find the minimum transportation cost. Minimum transportation cost. we will denote by z. Now see here how to write 2 into 3 plus 5 into 3 plus 4 into 4 plus 7 into 1 plus 3 into 3 plus 6 into 1. If you calculate, the value will be rupees 59. In this way, you have to solve the problem by penalty method or Google's approximate method. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.